What's going on, everybody? This is Alex KGB. Today we're doing a weapon spotlight for bloodied Gauss rifle. Take a look at this. This is regular Gauss rifle. This is bloodied Gauss rifle. Now, bloodied Gauss rifle is doing almost as twice much damage as the regular one. They're both the same level, this one is 400 damage. The other one is 233 versus 400. Now the damage can also be increased by the sneak attacks. This is also a good example why you should always check vendors, because people sell stuff that might be good. Now I do like Dual Slayer single action revolver, so I'm buying that. It's doing additional limb damage, which is kind of good for a sniper build. Let's talk about the Gauss rifle. Someone told in the comments that this is one of the best rifles in the game. I'm somewhat agree, but I do find my current blinding hardened piercing sniper rifle that is doing additional 50% limb damage a lot better in terms of killing Scourge Beasts and other mighty beasts that have a lot of HP, because I can spam attack from the stealth, focus on the limb for additional 50 damage and kill them pretty quick. With this Gauss rifle, however, I did have a PvP experience where my sniper rifle couldn't really do much damage for some reason. I think there was a bug, or maybe additional limb damage in PvP doesn't really work, so I couldn't kill the player, while the bloodied Gauss rifle did kill him with one shot. Gotta give it that. Overall, it's a good weapon. You can mostly take anything with one shot from the sneak attack, because it's gonna be 2.5 damage or 3.75 if you're doing it at night. Also, it's good versus death claws, so a couple of shots did take the death claw down from the stealth attack. It didn't work as well, however, versus Scourge Beast. It was hard to kill the Scourge Beast. It took me 3 attempts because Scourge Beast was killing me first, and low HP was a factor to that. So it did take me multiple attempts to take the Scourge Beast down, and I couldn't one-shot it. Now, the regular aim was off, and going through VATS, you would need some time to charge the rifle, because if you shoot without charging the rifle up to 100%, well, you're going to do only half of the damage, max damage that you have in the description. So instead of 410, it becomes 205. That was another factor. So it was really hard to aim. If you're using VATS, it still takes a long time, and several shots wouldn't be as easy as spam with some other rifle. It does a lot of damage, but it's really hard to spam attack. It's really hard to attack in the VATS effectively, because every time you'd have to charge it 200%. Now, while testing on the Merler Queen, the same thing happened. I did several attacks, and then I had to charge fully and shot. She would have killed me. If she wouldn't be fighting another robot, the Merler Queen would definitely killed me. So another drawback. So very big enemies are harder to take down just because of the charge time and I guess less effectiveness from the sneak attacks. Maybe if you're having like modifiers, you have silencer, maybe it's going to be more effective. But mid-size enemies that do have a lot of HP, like Deathclaw, or in this example the bears, if you go for the head or for the weak spot, you charge it completely from the sneak attack, yes, you can take your enemy down with one shot. Now, Gauss rifle is affected by the rifle perks, so I would definitely take all the rifle perks. I would take the armor penetration. All this gonna help your damage. I can increase the damage with the adrenaline perk if I'm killing multiple enemies up to 600, and then also picking an adrenaline mutation with the low HP, you can pump another 50% in at very low HP, so that'd be up to 900. Technically, if you're shooting something down at night, theoretically you're doing more than 3000 damage right there, and you probably should be doing one shot on the Scourge Beast or Queen or other huge creatures, but that's not happening. I'm not sure if that's a bug or there may be some problem with armor penetration, but apparently it's not doing as much damage as stated. So is this an effective weapon? Yes, somewhat effective. It does a lot of damage. Is it difficult to manage? I think so. It's hard to get a good shot. VATS is not as effective. You might be good at killing things, but if you're running bloodied with low HP, If something shoots your back, it's just going to be taking too long of a time to recharge and shoot it down. I would go with semi-automatic rifles if you're going with a blooded build, but not really with the Gauss rifle. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this spotlight video for bloodied Gauss rifle. This was Alex KGB. Click that like button, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and bye-bye.